Sara, does he really have a chance in the Democratic primary? You said just moments ago you think he should have run as an independent. I know he's considered that as well and thought similarly, I can't win, therefore I won't do it. You think he has a chance as a Democrat?
I think he might. I agree, you know, to the point about his polling operation. It's very good. His team is very good. He has some of the best operatives in either party working for him, and they will run a good campaign if he does this. I think it's a long shot to be the Democratic nominee, but, you know, if you look back to the 2016 Republican primary, just think of every month there was a different front runner, and it's still very early in this process. You know, we're going to see people up and down, you know, December, January, February, March, and this could go on for quite some time, and it's not actually crazy to think that this could go to a convention for the Democrats. And so there will be many opportunities for him to gain share as these other candidates depart the stage. And ultimately, if this gets down to really a three-person race where it's Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, and a TBD moderate, and he's the TBD moderate, he'll be the nominee.
Hey, Sara, one other point Frank made this morning was that potential support for Bloomberg is invisible right now, given that some states don't include independents in Dem polling. How valid is that?
Well, I think that's right. And I think there's, you know, still, you know, potentially some Republicans who would be attracted to Michael Bloomberg's candidacy. Although I will point out, we talk about him like he's a moderate and he's not. He's actually moved quite far to the left. Not so much on economic issues, but when you think about the soda tax wars in New York City, that's pretty far afield of American mainstream thought. So I don't sort of assume that he can be a moderate candidate in the end. But at least in the Democratic primary, he's a moderate. And I think that he will do a better job litigating this argument than Joe Biden has. And I think it's a very important argument for the country to have, which is he's right about the fact that, you know, people shouldn't be embarrassed by their success. We should encourage success. And what the Democrats, who are the front runners, Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders, have done is demonize wealth, demonize success. And there's a lot of Democrats and a lot of Republicans very fearful of that.
Sara, the markets are moving lower this morning on comments by President Trump saying that he has not agreed yet to roll back the tariffs. What are your take? What's your take on, you know, how this process is going forward and what that means in terms of negotiating with the Chinese?
Well, you know, the president, as we know, you know, tends to be fairly open, fairly direct, says what he's thinking. That's unusual in American politics, and it has repercussions, you know, as you just pointed out, with the markets. And so I don't know that it means anything. You know, it could be posturing to the Chinese. It could be that he'll change his mind at, you know, 4 o'clock today. I think we've seen that before. As far as the process itself, it's unusual because it's so out in the open. And typically in previous administrations, you know, there would be a very organized process where diplomats and more junior people, you know, ran this through in a private setting. And the president only spoke when a deal was complete, or maybe spoke once or twice during the process. And that's just not the way he does things. And so as a result, you know, we spent a lot of time talking about it, and it may mean a lot and it may mean nothing.
Sara, when you look at polling, when you look at political strategy right now, do you think Bloomberg, whether it's the Democrats or whether it's the independents, can, I know this is a strange phrase, but can he overcome his wealth in this very populist, some would say pitchfork environment?
I think he needs to embrace his wealth. His wealth is a good thing. He's been very successful and he's been very generous. And a lot of the causes he donates to, I think many people don't agree with, but he also does a lot for the arts and education and helping sick people. And he should celebrate his wealth. And, you know, it would be ironic if that was the debate that was happening in the Democratic primary. And it was a Democrat who convinced the country that wealth is good, paying taxes is fine, but it should be fair and proportional. And I think that's a healthy thing, and I think that ultimately he could attract a lot of independents, you know, sort of maybe Republicans who don't love the president, if that's what his campaign is about. However, if his campaign is about, you know, only gun control issues, taking away, you know, people's big gulp, you know, health care for all, and ultimately he tries to compete with these Democrats on issues of the left, he's not going to be successful, because ultimately the people who love Elizabeth Warren and appreciate her candidacy, he's never going to match her on that. He's going to have to carve out a different, you know, piece of the Democratic primary and be thinking toward a general that can attract people who, for whatever reason, you know, may not support the president.